Well, yeah, so about a fast forward up until about a week ago, a good friend of mine, he was bedridden for about 6 months. His wife just took care of him, and me and Ashley just did whatever running around needed to be done. Just friends and family just all pitched in to help out. But he was pretty much one of my closest friends here in Tonga. Spent the last 5 years with him, built his house with him. So our relationship just was really, it was a good one. It was strong, and we just loved each other a lot. And then last Saturday, I got a phone call, and he had passed away, which was really, really, really hard to hear. I mean, we all knew it was kind of coming, and we kind of talked about it and stuff, but nothing can prepare you for something like that. So we had to start planning the funeral things. And in Tonga, you deal with things like this as a family. You deal with things like this on your own. There's not a company that the body goes to, and the family does everything. And I was able to be there through every step of it, and I definitely, I experienced my own father dying, and it was devastating. And my whole life, I had just, since my father had passed, it was so devastating to our family and so destructive that I felt like it was just like something off about it. The most naturalist things are to be born and to die. And so why is death so destructive? And so I look at how here in Tonga and the Tongans deal with death, and not to say that it's not any easier for them, because it's not, but how they deal with just the whole thing, I mean, it just seems much more healthier to me. So anyway, the family all got together, and they had decided that I was going to be, all wanted me to be the fa'apu, which a fa'apu is like the honored guest of the funeral. They sit next to the body, and so they asked me to be it, and I really didn't feel like I should have been. I mean, don't get me wrong, I felt very honored that they would even think of me, but there was nobody here to represent his family. He's British, and his kids are over in London, and they weren't able to make it out for the funeral, so I stood in their place. And so there was a lot of pride in that, because I got to meet his three kids, and they were just amazing, and they had all the qualities of their dad, but even more so. So it was a big honor to do that, and it was a big honor for carrying his casket down the road to where the burial site was, and I got to carry the front of the casket, and I just have never felt a pride like that, and it's just been really, really, really hard. When you have close friends on a small island like this, you're really cut off from the whole world out here, and when you have a really good friend, it's definitely really important to keep those friends, because, you know, when you lose a friend like that here, it's more devastating, because there's not a lot of other people that I feel that way about on the island. And plus, he was just an amazing guy, and he was supposed to help me build the camp. So I've just been in like this daze for a week, but the day of the funeral, about 3 hours after the funeral, I had to bring Ashley to the airport. She was flying back to the US, So I had to say goodbye to my wife, which she's gone for about a month. So I'm here with just the kids by myself, and but just not having the one person that you need to comfort you through the time like this. I'm so used to having Ashley there every step of the way, and you know, it's amazing and it's awesome that she got to go home, but it's pretty hard for me at the same time. At the same time, it's really hard for me. And then the same night my friend died, my dog got really sick. And then it just walked off into the bush and died somewhere, and I can't find it. I've been searching for, like, all day today, looking for this dog. And it's just, it sounds like a start of a country song. We had a crazy Category 5 cyclone, wiped out my house, cut my Achilles tendon partly with a roofing iron all the way through my leg. Six of my hard drives broke. I lost all that video footage. My laptop broke, so I lost everything. Now it's just dealing and coping with life here on the island without my friend. Just trying to comfort and be there for his wife as best as I can, even though, you know, there's nothing I can do to make her feel any better. So it's just rough. It's just been rough. Everything's rough right now. It's not fun at all. Oh, but I'm home, so I'm gonna stop talking. Au revoir to Malobito for those that help and give to our family so that we can keep doing what we do here. And it's just, I'm tired. Giving up sounds easy sometimes, even though I know I'm not going to, but. And then I haven't been able to work on my house. Just everything kind of got messed up. It took longer than I expected to even get building on it. Been waiting 6 years to do this. I mean, waiting my whole life to do this, but I've been waiting 6 years since we moved here to do this, and it just means I have to trust God more, which is a great place for me to be anyway. I don't want to be in a position where I don't need to have faith in Christ, you know? That's the whole reason why I'm here. Otherwise, there's no point in anything. But we are making a huge difference in the kids' lives here. I mean, that's important. And it's important to show these kids who God is, but not with just our words, but with our actions and our lifestyle. And when the two kind of come together, it all makes sense to them. So it's good. So, take one day at a time. All right.